Humanistic learning approach. And in the first part of the lecture, we talked of the basic of humanistic learning. And in the process, we talked about Bowler, COMBS, Rogers, and Master. Today, we shall discuss separately about firstly COMBS, then Rogers, and again Master. You must be remembering some basic aspect of humanistic learning approach. And we told, though they differ on certain points, but there are some common points due to which they all are being called as humanistic psychologists. So, in the previous lecture too, these names along with the name of some other which we have already discussed. So today we shall discuss about COMBS, Rogers, and most importantly the
Maslow.
Firstly, we shall discuss about COMBS. You can see, and since our third COMBS was very much associated with learning, so his learning aspect has been focused, and how learning and humanistic approach as per COMBS is related. Humanistic psychology and COMBS as one of the member of this school of thought. So this is all about the COMBS. You can see here the individual behavior can be changed when his beliefs and perception are modified. So the focus is that beliefs and perceptions are more important, and without changing the belief and perceptions of an individual, his behavior cannot be changed. That so in order to change the behavior of any individual learner, firstly you have to try to change his or her beliefs and perceptions. And you have already known to the concept perception, because it will come in the lecture again and again. We perceive the thing as we are, not the things are. Though it is very much related to projective technique of personality measurement, but we perceive any concept on the basis of our previous knowledge. And this mind setup which we have made due to our previous knowledge. So that is perception. When we were discussing a point, we told ki if you ask what is this, you as a student may tell about O. But when a liberal will say, he will say an object that is round in nature, because neither 0 nor O of English alphabet is known to him or her. So his or her perception to the object will be only of a round thing. Are you understanding? This is the real meaning of perception. When we see, when he sees the things differently, he will behave in a different way. Matlab, in order to behave differently, he or she has to look different. His perception, his angle of vision has its bearing on different behavior. To change behavior, one must change an individual's perception. Are you understanding? So you have understood perception. You know certain ways of changing the perception. Suppose a person who has not seen a cow, and they are told certain characteristics of cow. He or she has not got the holistic view of cow as a concept. Then he or she will not be able to narrate, because he or she has listened cow as a concept on the basis of their separate characteristics, now as a whole. So perception will be made only if the all elements of the concept concerned are integrated together. Humanist perceives two parts in learning. As per COMBS view, acquisition of new information and personalization of acquired information. As soon as you receive any information, the second step is that you personalized it. It means it goes in your already fund of knowledge and amalgate differently. And when you get it personalized, it becomes your own. So, acquisition of knowledge and its personalization. It means how you have understood. You have made your own perception on the basis of the previous knowledge and the knowledge which you have gained. So, two parts of learning, acquisition of new information and personalization of acquired information. The problem is not how to present the subject matter. Rather, to help the students to draw personal meanings from the subject matter. COMBS is of the view that the presentation of the matter before the learner is not important. But to make the learning material personal to him or her is more important. Because before getting the new information, he or she is having so many informations, and the informations will react together in order to get its stability. So, personal meaning from the subject matter. And if the concept gets personal meaning, the perception of the individual learner becomes clear. Major goals of humanistic education as perceived by COMBS: to accept the learner's needs and purposes and to create educational experiences for the development of learners' unique potential. Firstly, you have to take care of the learner's needs. The matter which the learner will perceive that it is not important for him or her will not provide him educational experience. Suppose you all are going to be a teacher. You all are prospective teachers. In due course of time, you have to play certain roles to be played by a teacher. So whenever anybody makes you familiar with the roles played by a teacher and you get experience from the given information, you will get your own perception. And that is more meaningful for you. You will not try to listen the learning material that is useful for a footballer, not for a teacher. Development of learners in a unique potential. And everybody receives the same information, even then the impact will be a little bit different. To develop learner self-actualization and feelings of personal education. We have already discussed about self-actualization, we will again discuss today. But I told, the self-actualization means to get the peak of his or her potential. If you have to be a good teacher, what is your level? So you will try to actualize yourself. No, this is not the level. I have to become a little bit more efficient. So that is the real meaning of self-actualization. To accept the learner's needs and purposes, we have already covered. To develop learner's self-actualization, where you can go, what potential you are having, whether you have realized your potential or not. So the peak of your potential, to get the peak of your potential is self-actualization, and maybe when we will discuss about the Maslow, we will learn more about the concept of self-actualization. So in the beginning part of the lecture, the first part of the lecture we have already covered. And feelings of personal awareness. Yes, I have to become a teacher. I know how to write on the blackboard, how to put questions before the class. So you know related teaching methods. You know teaching skills. So you are feeling adequate. So the potential you are having, you have channelized and have got the peak, you can get. So to foster the acquisition of basic skills and competencies, personal, interpersonal, communicative, academic, etc. So you have, in order to get self-actualization and personal adequacy, since you have to be a teacher, you have to develop the competency related to personal. And personal is very comprehensive concept. It is psychological, it is physical. So as a person you have to develop, you have to grow in order to self-actualize. Interpersonal. How to be happy. Interpersonal is a communication that is between two people. So interpersonal. Whether you have learned how to behave or not. Whether you have learned how to transact or not. So communicative. Whether you have become an effective communicator or not. That is essential. And academic. Whether you are knowing more about your subject or not. You have got this knowledge of pedagogy or not. So academic, aspect is important. So what COMBS conclude that to foster the acquisition of basic skills and competencies is very much important. And what are those competencies? That is personal. You have to grow personally. As an individual, you have to learn, you have to internalize about the related concept of interpersonal communication, you can say, and other communicative skills. And of course, academically, you must be sound. You must have the knowledge of pedagogy, knowledge of psychology, knowledge of the content matter that you are going to teach. Second part of the major goals of humanistic education: to recognize the importance of human values. This is the basic of humanistic psychology. We have already discussed ideal values. To recognize the importance of human values, perceptions and values in the process of education. So you must recognize human values. You must recognize that perception is important. You must require, you must know that values in the process of education is essential. If there is no value in the process of education, this is not education as per the COMBS. To create and develop the learning environment or climate that is supportive, challenging, understandable, free from threat and exciting. When we were discussing about the basic aspect of learning, humanistic learning approach, we have already told that the classroom environment and the relationship between teacher and learner is very important in this humanistic approach. And COMB is also telling the same thing. This threat will come again when we will read about the roaches. So to create and develop the learning environment or climate that is supportive, challenging, understandable, free from threat and exciting. So as Kong suggests us that we teacher, we learners have to create or have to have an environment that is supportive in nature, that is challenging in nature, that is understandable, and the environment of the classroom is free from any threat. The students are not worried, they are not puzzled and perplexed, they are free and exciting. Exciting means the learners are thinking that he or she is going to get something new. It's useful. It is interesting. So you are understanding the meaning of excitement. So calm as a humanistic psychologist have told about the teaching learning process. And in the teaching learning process, we have to take care of human values, and of course we have to create an environment that is free from any threat and it is challenging in nature. The learners are free and they learn and gets his or her own perception, and they are interested in the system because the knowledge which he or she is getting becomes personal to them. So to form the personal perception in order to change views, beliefs are important as pronounced by the COMBS. So this is all about COMBS as a humanistic psychologist. Thank you.